As a communication coach and trainer, I want to tell you a story which I call a partner in action story. When you go to the airline check-in counter, you know the person who helps you behind the desk? You never see them again, right? Well, on one particular trip, years ago, I was traveling with my colleague Robbie. We were flying from Moscow to Seattle with an overnight in Heathrow. And somewhere between Moscow and Seattle, our bags got lost. You should know that this was the third time this happened to my colleague Robbie with the same airline. He was not a happy camper. We were tired, we had jet lag, and yet we know that these partner skills work. So we dragged ourselves back into partner and headed over to the lost luggage desk to fill in the forms. We greeted the woman at the desk, and she started to fill in the paperwork for us. It took 45 long minutes to do all the paperwork. And the whole time, we managed to stay in partner. When we were finished, we asked if there was some kind of compensation we could have to replace some of our items. She said, unfortunately, since you flew economy, all we can offer you is $75. So we politely accepted. Okay, that's lovely, thank you. Now, keep in mind, during those 45 minutes that we were talking to her, we had a delightful conversation, chatting about different things. We found out that she was originally from Romania and that her name was Rita. And at the end of the conversation, we said our pleasant goodbyes. Now, 2 days later, our luggage shows up, which was a good thing because we had to work for the next 5 days. Fast forward, at the end of that week, we headed back to the airport for our return flight to Europe. We had already done the online check-in, so all we had to do was drop off our bags at the counter. And when we walked up to the counter, you're never going to guess who we saw. Exactly, Rita. The woman who a week before had filled in our paperwork was the same woman taking our bags. We were amazed. So when we saw her, we were like, hey, Rita, how's it going? And Rita responded, oh, I'm good. I'm so glad you got your bags. And we replied back, yeah, thanks a lot for helping us with that. So the next thing I know, she gives us this look, and she does the raised eyebrow, you know, like somebody's in trouble. And with a slightly devilish attitude, she says very officially, may I see your tickets, please? Well, I was just about to explain that we'd already done the check-in when Robbie kicked me, and it's like, Amy. Oh, that means shut up and just do what she's asking. Got it. So we said, yeah, sure. And we handed our tickets to her. 5 minutes later, Rita comes back, hands us our tickets, and says, how does business class to Heathrow sound? We couldn't believe it. And I got to tell you, those headsets in business class are awesome. The learning from me is that if you really want to start, or that you really do want to start every relationship as if it's forever. One, because you never know. And two, more importantly, by stepping into every relationship as if it's forever, even if you don't get what you want in the short term, in that moment, you're still building partner muscles. So you'll be ready for when it really counts. That's my tip for today. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to visit my website or check out my YouTube channel. And also check out my book, The Ego Tango, for more tips on becoming a more powerful communicator. Thanks for tuning in and happy partnering.